Good afternoon, everybody. I, Sonal Roy, take pride in welcoming the Director General of Times Group of India, Mr. Vikesh Wallia. He pins on his sleeve the honor of being an alumni of IIM Ahmedabad, ISB Hyderabad, and Wharton US. For nearly two decades at Times Group, he played key role in Times, partnering with The Economist and BBC. He also launched Mumbai Mirror and as well student edition of the Times of India. Prior to Times Group, he spent over two decades with FMCG companies of global repute like Imperial Leather, Goodnight, Shaw Wallace, and Balsara. He specialized in setting up new businesses and mergers and acquisitions in FMCG business. I would like to conclude by inviting Sir to grace the seminar with his experiential prowess. Thank you.
When I get invited to schools like this, I keep wondering that what is the invitation for? If the invitation is for you to listen to a talk, I think there are better ways to do it. There are better TED Talks. You can hear them at your leisure in your own way. If you want to learn something through reading, you have best of the books that are available. And if you want to know something more, there is always a Google. So why do you get me here? What am I here for? I can't serve these three purposes any better. TED Talks are far superior. They are being created by professional speakers. I'm not a professional speaker. Books are authored by the best of the authors. You get the best of the knowledge. When you get me here, I would recommend that you use the time to talk. So I have a couple of slides for you. And thereafter, what I would like very much, and I urge you, is to talk to me, question me, and whatever is there in your mind that you want to know, that can be answered now in some way, whatever will be possible for me. So here we start. The topic I chose is that know the jobs that don't exist yet. We all prepare, we all know that, okay, one has to go for MBA, because there's big demand for managers. The management staff is in big demand. One has to go for dentistry. One has to go for medical. So that is all basis the past. But how much future do we look at? And how many schools are preparing their students for the future? And how many students are themselves getting prepared and reading for the jobs that don't exist? Take it from me, whatever you're studying here is only a transit for next 3 to 5 years maximum. In 3 to 5 years' time, the world is going to change. And whatever is the changed world, if you don't start preparing for it today, as you are passing out, and you will be getting some good jobs in a couple of months' time, you have to also simultaneously prepare yourself, keep an eye on what is the future, where are the future jobs. So one of the favorite slides that I have is, please don't be a taxi driver. Now, taxi driver is a job that almost anyone can get. And of course, these Uber jobs are also available. A taxi driver can't make more money at the exit time than what he made at the entry time. Probably at the entry time, he can make a little more money. But at the exit time, he will certainly not be making more money than what he was getting on day one or year one of his salary. The future belongs to people who can bring about value creation. As a matter of fact, the future organizations are going to be organizations that will simply be a network which will be location neutral. It will just be a network of people who are working in different locations but having a common cause to create a common value. And the reward is not going to be salaries. Reward is going to be the share of value creation. 20 years at Bennett Coleman, Times of India, I worked. The peon that I had in my office was drawing a salary of 63,000 rupees. That salary was not worth. He simply got it because there was a salary structure, there was an HR department, personal department, they will give increment to people. year after year, irrespective of, you know, gauging what is the value creation, value contribution. The next person who is going to replace him will be only at about 10,000 rupees or 15,000 rupees, whatever is the minimum wages of the state. And he will always continue at that salary, probably 10% more in 3 years, 5 years' time. If he doesn't want, let him go out, somebody else will come. So don't be a taxi driver. Be the person who will create value. Now, having said that, the software is going to disrupt traditional industries in the next 5 to 10 years. I can imagine you've been sitting here 3 days. Digital is the most talked about subject today. Probably there's an overdose also of digital, but my subject is slightly different than being a pure digital. So let's have a look at what is going to happen. The artificial intelligence is here. I need not give you the detail of it. In summary, what I can tell you is that it's not people who understand computers. Last 20 years, 25 years, we have been trying to understand computers. Now, computers understand us. That is AI all about. So, when computers start understanding, the Uber knows that, you know, Vikesh has come to so-and-so place, he also has to go back. They'll keep a track. They'll probably, data mining will be done, and they'll probably jack up rate for my return than what they brought me here for. Airbnb is there, the largest hotel company, without any hotel rooms. And then you have Watson, which is the IBM software for all the lawyers. And then you have Tricorder, which is going to monitor your health in such a way that all of you sitting here, you take it from me. I'm sitting today with all the centurions. Each one of you is going to cross 100 years of living. It's a fact. And this will really happen in your own lifetime. You will see and remember this day that someone on 24th of September told us that each one of you is going to be living at least 100 years, no stopping. And then, of course, you have the Khan Academy, which is going to transform, change the way education is done. IBM Watson gives you about 90% accuracy versus 70% human accuracy on any of the legal general inquiries that you have. Because most of the world, 80-20, 80% is routine work, 20% special work. So whatever 80% work is there, that can be attended by Watson. And for balance 20%, people will have to prepare themselves, and that is what is going to make difference. Mechanical cars versus the technical cars, you must have been told, you must have been seeing these WhatsApp coming every day, that what is going to be the future of Toyota, what is going to be the future of GM Motors, the Volkswagen, and the Honda, and the cars that are going to come is Tesla, Google, and the Microsoft cars, which will run the show here. So all that will be happening. Autonomous cars are going to be there. And your children, if I say that you're going to be living 100 years, you also take it from me that none of your children will ever probably acquire a driving license. They will also not own the cars. That's the way the world is going to change with autonomous cars. The city's landscape will change completely because the parking area and the other area, which are already created, and we are dying. We are all the time talking about parking not available. That area is going to be an agriculture, farming area, or some playground, or something else. So car accidents are going to come down dramatically. The deaths will come down from currently 1.2 million per annum worldwide to just about 20,000. So imagine so many people, a million people, over a million people, will be living much longer than what they are living today. What will happen to the insurance companies who are in this business of selling car insurance? They'll run out of business. They'll have to do something else. So all that is going to transform. And the debate of fossil energy versus the solar energy is always live there. And everyone talking about the electric cars already here in this country. London has already announced that by 2030, there will not be any fossil fuel cars in the city. Each car has to be an electric car or a solar car. Oil-based economies are going to crash. They're going to transform. They won't crash, meaning they'll transform. And they just don't know right now what to do and how to transform. So if people are eyeing that, you know, I will have a job in Gulf, I'll have a job in GCC countries, those dreams may not come true. Those jobs might be elsewhere. So you have to start thinking, and you've got to keep your eye on all these things. Desalination of salt water. Everyone is talking shortage of water. Right now, Sadhguru is running a campaign of planting trees alongside the rivers and taking care of water. Of course, we need to do all that. But the future will not probably be that. Future will lie in desalination, in picking up water from the sea and drinking. That's going to happen. Today, it is very costly to do that process. That process is getting cheaper every day. So all that will change hospitals versus the tricorders. The tricorder will do your retina scan. It'll do your blood test. It'll do your breath test via your mobile. And by 2036, 1 year life expectancy is going to increase per annum. If today that is happening at the rate of, say, every 5 years, your life is going up by about a year, by 2036, which is just about 20 years from now, every year your lifespan will increase by 1 year. There will be so much of medical advancement and so many other things will happen that people will not let you die and you will definitely live nothing less than 100 years. The manual versus the robot debate is also very, very common. All these are all, you know, things that you have been seeing every day. So the agri robo is going to come for about, say, 5,000-7,000 rupees, and he is going to run the agriculture. 3D printers, smartphone, 3D scans, school versus the Khan Academy, all that is really happening now. So what will be old jobs versus the new jobs? 70% of the present day jobs are going to disappear in no more than 20 years' time. That's the pace of jobs disappearing. Today also, the whole country is wondering where are jobs going, and then the Modi is, you know, looking for answers that where are the jobs? And where is the slide? So these jobs are going to vanish in about 20 years' time, 70% of them. But new jobs will get created. The whole economy, the whole job scenario will run basis something else. So this we have seen, the taxi driver replacing a driver, being replaced by a driverless car, and surgeon replaced by a robot. AI boards are developing their own languages, and drones are painting the buildings and everything. You know, you need not go and do the brushing everywhere. Drones will do all that painting and all that. Virtual reality is changing retail experience, and technology is disrupting as never before. So where is the new job? Where are going to be the new jobs? So the new jobs are going to come in the area of virtual reality. So this is where I wanted to arrive before just taking you into the landscape of digital world. This is where the new jobs are going to come. These jobs will be in virtual reality. The biggest jobs will come in this area. It's not only the technology part, but also the additional servicing part, the marketing part, and the finance part that will be needed. But the area will move into virtual reality in a very big way. The visual rendering, the tracking system, the visual perceptions, the light and optics, the virtual worlds, and the 3D modeling. This is going to be a huge area where maximum jobs will come. The next job that are going to come is machine learning. So computer will learn on its own. The robot will learn on its own that what do you want? Okay, if you came here, you went last time to a particular building, your facial recognition is registered, and only when you have the same face, you can enter. If somebody else tries to enter in your name, he will be denied an entry. So those kind of machine learnings will take place, the trees and networks, support vector machines, the model selection, the recommendation systems, the hidden Markov and the POMDP models, and the programming languages like Python, and all these things will determine the future jobs. People who will be able to relate with all these things, it is not the servicing of the loans, or it is not selling of some products which are there, but everything will get driven by this new product, by this new technology. And those who will be in a position to get to all these things will derive maximum job satisfaction. And the next thing that is going to happen is the big data. All of us, we know that the moment you try to reach your website, make my trip, and you try to buy a ticket, the guy knows that so-and-so place, so-and-so location, better not check the price from the same computer at the same place. So if you have to find out new price, you better go to a new location and try to find it out from another place, because data mining, the data collection, everything, the whole of National Stock Exchange problem that has arisen, the MD had to be leaving, was simply because of the algorithm trading. A concession of less than 5 to 10 seconds can take away the job of the most reputed lady in the finance business. Mrs. Chitra had a fantastic career, and suddenly she was asked to leave. The whole IPO of 10,000 rupees, $2 billion, is in the waiting, mainly because she couldn't understand that what can data mining or the 5 seconds in algorithm trading can mean. So the data mining, the cloud computing, the Linux, and the algorithm trading, training and tabular softwares and the perception and the ensemble learning. These are going to be the things of future. And if these are not addressed and people don't prepare themselves, because the preparation process, the human preparation process, will take 3 to 5 years. So maybe you have a ready job now that will come to you within the next couple of months, but that job will change its meaning, will lose its shine and interest in next 3 to 5 years' time, you take it from me. So as soon as you leave this place, you will probably have to be gearing up that what is going to be the next thing. Cybersecurity is the biggest thing, because everything is going to be digital. Then the cybersecurity will take over everything else, the cryptography, the forensics, the cloud computing, and the number theory, the secure architecture. You talk about anything on cybersecurity, and unless you don't understand it, you will be marketing more of cybersecurity than you will be marketing toilet soaps or detergents. So that is going to be the future. Wireless network security, the product will be there, but then you will be doing same things for a different product, and you will have to understand the product. So that is what is going to change the whole world. The fintech is going to transform the banking industry, the financial world, and blockchain, the cryptocurrency, the big data, artificial intelligence, and the bots, and the Internet of Things. Those things will change the world. And all that will not take 20 years and 30 years. All that is going to happen in maximum next 5 years' time. The inbound marketing, the digital marketing, will take lead over any other marketing. So the inbound marketing, the buyer persona, digital ecosystem, all these things will require a new learning and a continuous learning. Gone are the days that people could, pass out from a B school and forget about reading a book or updating themselves. Majority of us have been like that. We passed out, we never looked back at what is there. Only some of us believed and subscribe to continuous learning, and that is what has made difference to the life of some people, but majority have not done. But that will not be the case for the future generation and the future jobs. You will all have to continuously learn. So are you ready for that? That's the talk that I had for you. And as I told you that I have very few slides, but I would like to talk to you. So if there's something in your mind, I would like to answer that more than what I would like to be talking to you.
Sir, print media, last 5 years, it has grown only in India, China, and some countries. Not in every country. Print media has declined a lot in the last 5 years. IRS only, I just read their report. It has been grown in vernacular languages, not in the English and other prime languages.
It's not going to grow. Don't worry about that. It's not going to grow. Because now the 4G is there, the Reliance Jio is there, and lots of websites are launching their vernacular editions. So people will get it in their language in digital form. So they need not even go for print. So print has to go down. There is no doubt about this. It's only the resistance which is coming from people who are unable to change their habits. So, you know, people like me, if I have been brought up, you know, 60 years of my life or 55 years of my life, say 50 years, if I have been brought up on the diet of a newspaper, it'll be very difficult for me to change that diet. But the new generation, it's a matter of habit change.
Sir, then why vernacular is growing? Vernacular language newspaper is growing, sir.
It'll not grow. It's not growing anymore. Don't worry. It's not growing anymore. I set up the largest printing press for Bennett Coleman in the year 2014 or 2013. I set up the largest printing press for them. That size of printing press is not going to be set up anywhere in the world ever. As simple as that. When the capital expenditure in an industry comes down, you know that that industry is dying. The moment you stop buying, you know, a new clothing for yourself or your grandfather, if you look at him, he even say, no, I don't want a new shirt. But you want a new shirt even if you've got 10 new shirts in your wardrobe. Why? Because you are moving towards life and he doesn't want to move towards life. So that capital expenditure in the print media industry is already dying. It's not happening. It is very difficult even to service the plants which are there with existing companies the world over. As a matter of fact, the German company which used to manufacture the printing presses, that company has stopped working. So all the newspaper companies had to get together and tell them that, okay, even if you're not going to produce new machines, please continue to produce the spare part. They said it's not a viable model, we can't do it. So that company has been funded by all the newspaper industry put together just to supply them cars and that the parts. And the same thing is going to happen to cars. All these cars are going to vanish in no more than 10 to 15 years' time. So what will you do? What will Maruti do? Maruti will only continue to produce the spare parts as long as the government is allowing these cars to be driven on the road. But if the government like London has done, UK government has stopped from 2030, you can't drive a mechanical car or a fossil fuel-based car on the London roads, 2030. And Uber has already said, although they had the shock of their life by denial of taxi rights in London, but they said 2020, they will switch to only electric cars. So these things will happen parallelly. Print media is not going to grow. For sure.
Okay, sir. Sir, second question. Method of IRS, sir. What
method of IRS? That is an outdated. This is what is a denial mode. The industry is in a denial mode. The IRS method was not wrong. IRS method was wrong, right? And it was actually going down. So when you are dying, you don't want to admit that you are dying, because if you start admitting that you are dying, then people will stop coming to you, they'll stop bringing gifts to you. So, you are in a denial mode and you will say that, I'm not dying, I'm happily living, I'm partying, so continue to bring presents for me, bring advertising to me. So, this is a drama that the whole industry played, and Times Group being the biggest player in that had to lead. There was no other way out. Because if we agree and we admit that we are not growing, who will bring us advertising? As long as we are in that business, we'll continue to say that we are not dying. The print is special. Print is extra special. This is a, you know, a specialty of print. So those are all marketing gimmicks. You have the plant, you have to bring the brand, and you have to build the habit, and you have to keep the brand alive as long as possible. So, you know, if you are the first man to come in and you can continue to be the last man to stand, you end up making money. So New York Times and those Washington Post companies are not dying, are not dead yet. And they will not die. If they were to die, Bezos would not have been buying Washington Post. You know that he bought. Why? Because he knows it will not die. It will take minimum 50 years for a habit to die. And we know in the marketing pyramid, what comes at the bottom is, of course, the commodity and everything. Next up, and nearly the top of the pyramid, is the products that form your habits, the products that form your addiction. So those products, they give you maximum profit. The brands that are in these categories, habits, addiction, and internalization. So the brand that sit in your mind and the brands that sit in your heart, they are the brands that make maximum money. So IRS is just a gimmick. It's a drama which is happening, and there's just no way out. You seem to be coming from print media industry.
There have been parody about East India Comedy, All India Bakchod. I've been making parody of Times of India that it's more of an advertisement, less of the content with and the other, Economic Times, their sister newspaper. It is more famous for the better content. So what is the strategy behind the Times of India, you know, in the case of advertisement?
It's very simple strategy, the same strategy that your mother has been shouting at you that, you know, this is study time and you are standing with your friends outside and gossiping and doing this. But your father is not troubling you as much. Why? Because he knows that even if you are gossiping, there is a bit of learning in that. Every talking that you do to someone brings you some learning. So even if you're gossiping about, you know, the new phone, so you may be talking about phone, that to your mother, but to your dad, he knows you're talking about technology. That's the difference. So advertising is also content. If you don't know that you have the Amazon sale happening today, you will miss out on the biggest news. Is that a news or it is an ad? So it's a news. So advertising is also content. So as long as you understand that bit, why people buy Times of India versus any other newspaper, whereas the news content and probably percentage of news is much more in every other newspaper than Times of India, and still people buy Times of India. Why? Simply because even advertising is content. Suppose, you know, if your salary is 10 lakhs of rupees, you will not be saving any money. You will be spending exactly 100%. Whatever is your salary, you spend 100%. Why? Because even the saving is a buying. So what you save as a mutual fund, you have saved in mutual funds. That is your perception. But Times of India knows that you are buying mutual funds. So if by reading Times of India, getting the right advertisement of the appropriate mutual fund, you will be able to buy a better mutual fund. So your 10 lakh rupees value will increase by, say, 5%. So you don't know that you not only made your company, you are cribbing to your boss for not giving 5% increment, but that 5% extra money has come to you through the savings that you made on information that came through advertising. So advertising is important information. And there's no harm about that. And that's why people continue to buy.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving us valuable insight on artificial intelligence,
digitization, cryptocurrency, and dominance of robot over human. We are inspired by your great words, sir. We would like to hear from you on and off the campus.